Hey, you're watching Talent Talks, brought to you by Saba Software, the only series that's dedicated to making your managers of people better coaches. I'm Kris, Dunn, and I'm here to talk to you today about an important topic, BHAGs. Okay, you may be asking yourself, what is a BHAG? Well, a BHAG, simply put, stands for Big Hairy Audacious Goals. And that's the only time I'm gonna say all those words. Okay, what that means is it's a big goal that historically is designed to rally a company around like a single vision or a single initiative. Let me give you a couple of examples. I'm gonna glance down because I pulled these from the interweb. Here's one on organizational change. Transform this company from a chemical manufacturer into the preeminent drug-making company of the world. That was from Merck in the 1930s. Do you think they accomplished that goal? All you have to do is look on TV to know that they did. Here's another one, reputation. Become the company most known for changing the worldwide poor quality image of Japanese products. That was a BHAG at Sony in the 1950s. Now, I'm so young, I don't even remember the 1950s. All I know is Japanese products are really, really good. So obviously Sony and some of their fellow Japanese companies achieved that BHAG. So those are BHAGs. They're like goals that rally a company around like a single purpose or a single initiative. Now, how does that really come into play for the individuals who report to you? Well, one out of every 10 of your direct reports are gonna be incredible performers. And when it comes to goal setting for your best performers probably needs to look a little different than it does for average performers. So you can use BHAGs to really engage your highest performers, to give them a goal and not really tell them how they're gonna get there. It's really a challenge, and it's a way to really crystallize what they're working on for what I like to call big wins. So for individuals, BHAGs are really just trying to define what a big win could be for that high performer. And I went ahead and put down a couple on my laptop for you. Here's an example of what a BHAG could be for an individual at your company. And this is all position dependent, obviously. Build a 500K business by designing and marketing a new product line. Here's another one, redesign the production line layout to increase efficiency by 20%. Now, what's missing from those? Those are both examples of BHAGs that you could give an individual. They're big in scope. What's missing is you're not telling the person how to do it, because your highest performers don't need to be told, and a lot of times don't want to be told. They just want to know that there's a big challenge they can accomplish for themselves and for the company that's going to be a big win. It's going to help them from a career perspective, and it's going to help the company in ways that maybe their peers aren't capable of doing it. So when it comes to BHAGs, when you think about BHAGs for the individual, remember Merck, remember Sony, boil that down to the individual level and help that high performer define what a big win looks like in your organization without telling them what to do, and you'll have a BHAG as a goal for your highest performing individuals. Okay, that's it for today. If you like what you've heard here at Talent Talks, look below, hit us with a like, hit us with a comment. As always, thanks to Saba Software for supporting and sponsoring this series. I'm Kris Dunn for Talent Talks. We'll see you next time.